Hulk, my hotline has been ringing off the hook. I know yours has too. People around the country, all over the world, have been expressing tremendous concern at what happened to you. Can you give us a real quick update? What's the status of it?
Basically, it's going to be time, man. We're kind of boxed in right now, but I'm just real not happy about the way things went down, man. You know, when you talk about hotlines, the hotlines here, man, yeah, my phone's ringing off the hook, the Hulk Hogan hotline, but these kids are upset, man, because I promised them one thing. I was going to make this Hulkamania run forever. But it's so different now because, you know, I thought things were going to be different. You know, you got Bischoff, you know, playing the game, and nobody seems to have a handle on Ric Flair. I mean, when you talk about aggravation, you know, you might as well go ahead and put Flair's name at the top of the list. Everything he's doing has been a setup, and they've got me boxed in. Big deal.
I mean, it's a conspiracy. You take a look at Flair's. Even Bobby Heenan, who's made some ridiculous accusations.
Oh, man, they're all working together. I mean, it's as plain as the sun is shining. If you'd have to be a fool not to realize that Heenan, with Flair, they're all trying to set me up, you know. But the bottom line is this. There's nothing they can do about it. The 30-day return clause is okay.
Well, you may have boxed yourself in, I guess.
Yeah, and there's no way Ric Flair could pin me. And the way I feel right now, Ric Flair, he won the battle, but he's not going to win the war. Even if every 30 days made me fight Godzilla or King Kong, I'd be there. I'd be up for it because I've got these kids, man. I got these maniacs that I'm fighting for. But, you know, the bottom line is this. Whether it's Vader, whether it's one of Flair's buddies running around, and I'll climb in the ring no matter what it is. But the bottom line is, why don't we box Ric Flair in? Why don't we put Bischoff? Why don't we put all these clowns? Why don't we put money? Why don't we just shoot this thing straight? Why don't they make it a fair playground for all these athletes that we can get in the ring and find out who is the best wrestler?
You know, I would vote for that in a heartbeat, and I'd like to see it happen, Hulk. I really would, but I don't know. Today, it's just so confusing.
Well, let me tell you something, man. Ric Flair and everything he's got going the way Ric Flair is tooting his own horn, we might say. I got one more thing to say. You make sure all your ducks are in a row, because I know they are now, but you find Ric Flair for me. Why don't you throw this microphone up in front of his face when he's not ready like you do to me all the time?
Oh, come on, Hulk, give me a break. I didn't mean to impose.
No, I know whose side you're on, brother. But
please,
why don't you just ask
him? I'll ask him. If I get the chance.
You tell him, brother, knee or not, I'm ready for him.
All right, of course, Hulk Hogan. I've not seen him in that frame of mind for a long, long time. Not good, but I know he's going to be back. Wow.
And the first thing they do is they have a King of the Ring tournament. They're going to crown another king, and it happens to be Bret Hart. Well, I told them beforehand, I said, let me just tell you this right now. I've come up here at your request. I'm the king, and now you want to try to save somebody else as a king? But it happened to be Bret Hart, and I am a man of my word. He talks about integrity. Bret Hart, you're looking at a man who, when he says he's going to do something, will do it. And I came out there and I showed him who the real king was. And from that day on, Bret Hart and the king have not gotten along.
That's right.
Now that's right, Bret Hart. When I don't like somebody, I don't care what I say about them and I don't care what I do to them. Now, just because you can't stand the truth, just because when I say things about, hey, I can't help it that Bret Hart's mother is so old that she was a waitress at the Last Supper. You know? Hey, I can't help it that Bret Hart's father, when God said, let there be light, stew through the switch. That's not my fault, Bret Hart. You're from Canada. And I'll tell you this right now. If I own Canada and if I own hell, I'd rent out Canada and live in hell. Do you understand what I'm talking about? I don't care for you. I don't care for Canada. You're going to come down to the king's backyard. You're going to come to the Mid-South Coliseum in Memphis, Tennessee. And this is going to be a match like Memphis has never seen before. Because you're right, Bret Hart. I hate your stinking guts, and between me and you, pal, it's personal. Now, I know. I can hear him right now. Sure, there are a few misguided people, Bret Hart, that think you're a big deal. They think you really are the best there is, the best there was. There'll be just as many people who think the king is number one in Memphis, and I'm going to prove it to them, and I'm personally going to prove it to you, Hitman.
Thank you. Federation champion, Ric Flair.
I think Mean Gene Mann, executive chief.
What do you think they're talking about in London now? What do you think they're talking about in Los Angeles, New York, Chicago, and Atlanta? GA. I'm not through gloating. For all of you that thought we were through beat, kiss, stealing, wheeling, dealing, limousine riding, jet flying, son of a guns, on top of the WWF, you were wrong.
Wait a minute, I'm going to interrupt right there. Gentlemen, let me remind you that as the World Wrestling Federation champion, it is incumbent on you, Mr. Flair, to defend this title with dignity.
Let me reiterate one more time. If he, in all his infinite wisdom, had listened to the great one, to begin with, he'd be out here running the road. You know what? You'll hear them just as you hear those big veins and that massive body start to cramp up. And you know what you'll be then? Tell them, Mr. Perfect.
Perfect.
As everybody knows by now, and all the people know in their minds, Hulkamania is on the downfall.
Oh my goodness.
Well, there are other things to address. Wait a minute. As I stand here this very minute, it gives me great pleasure to stand here amongst great gentlemen and athletes such as this group of people.
Give me a break. So you picked up a little hardware recently.
Survival, Mean Gene. Survival is what it's all about. And that's what you've got standing here on this podium is a whole lot of survivors. And I'm going to put you right back where I promised. On the street and penniless.
You know, in all due respect, Ric Flair, I don't think I've ever seen...
What the-
You know a working man don't get nothing like that.
Easy, King. At least he's not settling by the pound. That's a bit expensive.
Now, normally, there's nothing I'd like more than to kick your head in. But I may be from England, but the last time I checked, my name's Stephen Regal, not Elton John, so I'll take the broads.
That's a smart move!
Well, the man's man is a thinking man's man, apparently.
I'm not kidding.
At least in the King's view. Apparently, we're not going to have a match between Regal and the Godfather.
What a night! Oh, what a night! Uh-oh, what's up now?
Hey, Regal. You know what, man? I really didn't think you were going to take the hold. So, to quote what a good friend of mine, Archie Bunker, says, England ain't nothing but a place full of fags.
Huh?
Fight!
Pinball. Boy, he really came in with that elbow. And I think Frazier stays.
One, two, three.
Lawler, you must really have underestimated the Hitman. I guess you haven't been keeping up with exactly what the Hitman can do. You went and jumped me after the King of the Ring tournament, and you beat me like a dog. That really bugs me. That's a line that you should never have crossed. That's fine, because you've crossed the line, and I am going to take you, and just like the kings of old, I will execute you, and I will chop your head off, and that'll be the last anybody ever hears of Jerry Lawler.
Fight! Can you dig it, sucker? Can you dig it, sucker?
To the king. So Duggan, you the one who stole it because you're so stupid. You are the one who asked for it. You challenged me. You maybe put me down with that 2x4. But now it's my turn to put you down. But the way I will put you down, Dr. Duggan, I don't need a 2x4. The only thing I need is just my hand, Axel Duggan. I will get you by that neck. And I will squeeze and squeeze and squeeze, Duggan. I will squeeze until you got just a little bit there to say, I give. And you will give, Axel Duggan, because what you asked for it, you will get it, and you will get it the giant way. Because now I'm mad, and when I'm mad, I'm mad. Believe me.
Thank you. guess what? The momentum. Yeah, the momentum that I have inside me right now can only think of one thing. Yeah. And that's not just taking the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt. That's destroying who the champion is right now. Let that be a guess to you. Yeah. Who could I possibly be talking about? You're a real, real big, tough guy, aren't you? But I'm telling you something right now. You're out of your league. And when I get you, yeah, when I get you, it's going to be a time that you're going to remember forever and ever and ever, unless one thing happens, and that's if I give you a Macho Madness hangover that gives you amnesia and you can't remember nothing. Yeah, but I'm talking to you right now. You've got my attention. You wanted my attention, you've got my attention. Okay, tough guy. Yeah, you want the Macho Man's reputation, you want to put a niche in your belt? Well, let it happen. Let it happen, yeah.
What makes you so macho? What makes you a man? And certainly I want to know, what makes you a savage? Randy Macho Man Savage. You put the three together, and when you put them against this man, Savage, you come up a loser.
Had to be a name he gave himself. Certainly the fans didn't call him Macho Man. Certainly no woman that I've ever known called him Macho Man. So Savage, you've been the champion, you've walked the aisle, been the cock of the walk, had everything the way you wanted it. No more, pal. It's Mr. Perfect and Ric Flair looking you in the eye, telling you we're the World Wrestling Federation champion, and telling you we know something you don't know. Woo!
What up, Mike?
Thank you.
Cheering for the Macho Man as well. Here we go.